What's up, everybody? It's Renfi here, and today I'll be talking about the map house. I'll be talking about strategies, I'll show you spots that me and my friend found by ourselves, and I don't really think they're discovered yet because I've never seen anyone use them. I'm going to show you pre-fire spots, wall bank spots, as well as trapdoors, and all the cameras, and also some cluster charges for fuse. So let's get right into it. Alright guys, let's start with the basics. This is a very, very basic strategy that doesn't really require a lot of, you know, coordination, teamwork, and experience to accomplish. So basically, what you're going to be doing is taking control of kids' bedroom first. So you're going to be sending Sledge or pretty much anyone that has a breaching charge. You're going to be breaching this window right here, and then you're going to be sending a drone in there. As soon as the drone lands, you want to jump on the bed, and from the bed you're going to have a clear overview of the whole room. And then if you see someone, just chuck grenades. If not, that's great, you have kids bedroom control. Now the second step is to get this guy in position. This is a very, very easy position to play because it's very hard for the defenders to shoot you out. So basically you're going to be going above the window, and you're going to have really good vision on this door and this door. So basically you're going to have a lot of map control from this guy being there. And you have to be careful on these danger areas. Those two danger areas are two places where the defenders can go outside and shoot you. This is pretty dangerous because this guy can shoot this guy repelling. And as soon as this guy is dead, you're going to lose a lot of map control. So this guy has to be very aware of people going outside from there and from there. And this guy needs to be aware of the door right here, because, you know, any defenders can go outside, and then they can shoot him and these two guys. So this guy really needs to be aware of his surroundings. The fifth guy is going to be a roamer, so he's just going to try and get some nice angles, maybe the bathroom, maybe trying to take control of construction. You know, the fifth guy is going to be a very flexible asset to the team.
So as soon as you have these two guys in repels and you have your armor somewhere, you really want to put pressure on Master's bedroom. So you're going to be destroying that window right here, and you're going to be pre-firing pretty much every spot. You want to put a lot of pressure on the defenders because they can't move anywhere. They have to fight you. So, you know, just use drones, flash grenades, frag grenades. And, you know, if you get to that stage, which is pretty easy to do, you're going to win this round.
So, you know, that was just a simple strategy for Master's bedroom. And as long as you understand those dynamics, you're going to be able to understand the rest of the video.
All right,
so this is the first guy that I was talking about in the strategy. So his role is to destroy that window and clear kid's bedroom. So, you know, just use a drone, jump on the bed, and as soon as you do that, you're going to be able to see pretty much everything. From there, you send grenades if you see someone, and if you don't, that's great, you have kid's bedroom control. This is the second guy that I was talking about. This guy is extremely important, and it is such an easy spot to use. You're often going to get kills from people roaming, and it's very hard from the defenders to dig that guy out, as you're just getting outgunned, and this guy can just strafe left and right very quickly. You know, it's just going to be a tough fight for the defenders to take that alley back, unless they do exactly that. This is the danger spot that I was talking about, and it's very easy to do, so the guy rappelling needs to be aware of that. If he hears a defender trying to break that wooden door, he needs to be aware that he's going to be flanked by the left side. And finally, here's the third spot. Basically, you just want to be spamming walls non-stop. You want to be using your drone. You want to be sending grenades, flash grenades, and put a lot of pressure on the defenders to try and dig them out. Here's one of the spots that me and my friend found. Basically, you want to be putting a deployable shield right here. And from the left side, you can go up and head glitch right here. You can strafe left and right. And it's just a great spot because no one will be expecting you there. Now, if you see that this video has a lot of views, you know, take that lightly. Maybe some people will be using it in the future, but as of right now, no one's using that spot. And if you see that the video is quite old, they might have patched that, because I don't really think that's something that they wanted players to use. So just, you know, keep that in mind. Here's another spot that I've never seen anyone use. As the defender, you want to be throwing a C4 right here in the middle, and you can head glitch this. Basically, you're going to be seeing their feet if they spawn construction, and you're going to be able to get a lot of kills through that door. Alright, so I'll show you some wall bank spots. You want to be standing right there, and then you're going to be spamming the left side right in the middle of the paint, and you're going to be headshotting anyone behind that wall that's camping.
Here's another camping spot that you can deny. You just stand on the first stair and then you shoot right there. And you're going to be killing any camper that stands in this very corner. Here's a great wall bank spot. Basically, you know, there's a lot of people when they're defending that camps right there. And what you want to be doing is going to the dining room and you're going to be firing through the ceiling at the very corner. And some of your bullets will be hitting that camper and he won't know what's hitting him. And by the way, the goal of those wall bangs isn't really to kill your enemy. It's more to make them change position and, you know, try to get them to be creative on the spot, which is going to make them do a lot of mistakes. Here's another one. You want to be standing in this spot and shoot to the right of the first line. And you're going to be nailing anyone that's in this corner. For this one, you're going to need some C4 and you can go right here on this little thing. Not a lot of people know about this. I've never actually seen anyone use that. And it's a great spawn killing spot for attackers spawning construction. This is another great spawn killing spot for construction. All you have to do is get on this little blue box and there you go. The attackers will never expect this. You probably already know about this one, but this is the way my team does it. We keep a guy in kid's bedroom and basically he's going to be the one firing as soon as he sees someone spawning APC. I'm staying in the bathroom looking at ducks, and as long as I don't hear firing at APC, I stay at bathroom. As soon as I do hear that, I jump to master's bedroom and now we have some great crossfire on the enemy. This is what you want to be doing as Ash. If you spawn ducks and you're getting shot from bathroom, you want to shoot back, you know, suppressive fire. It's always gonna make that guy back up, and then you're gonna go in office, and from there you use your ability to destroy the ceiling and you're gonna damage that guy a lot and possibly pick up the kill. And what's so cool about this is you can actually get on top of this thing and you can watch living room, you can watch construction, you can even make a hole if you want to and you know, get a sight of the inside of construction. I mean, this is just a great spot in general. No one's going to be expecting you to have those types of angles. Time for some cluster charge spots. Now this one is freaking nasty. It just clears out the whole backside of garage where people love to camp. So basically you put it there and then it's going to nuke the backside of garage. So basically put that cluster charge after thermite blows a hole through the door. And so it's going to force the enemies to walk into your guns or die from the grenades. Here's another cluster charge that not a lot of people use. You just put it there and it's going to be nuking the bathroom completely. After all of those grenades explode, you can take bathroom easily. Now I'll show you all four trapdoors on this map. This one is actually the most important one. You actually want to reinforce this ASAP as the defenders because you'll be using this spot that I'm looking at right now. And you know, if they take out this trapdoor, I mean, you're going to get exposed, so you're gonna have to find another way to protect the stairs. This trapdoor is actually pretty useless unless you're playing hostage rescue, but even then, it's not the best way to get in. This one is the most useless of them all. If you destroy that, you're going to be able to jump from the second floor to the kitchen stairs, which is not that big of a perk. This is the most popular one, and it's a pretty easy way to get into the laundry room, but you can't use it to shoot down at people because you can't go on the sides without falling down. And to conclude this video, here's all the camera spots. There's one right here. One right here in the garage, one in the gym, and last two are outside. One is close to Side Street, and the last one is to the left of the main entrance. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video. If you did, please consider subscribing as I plan on being really active on YouTube. And yeah, thanks for watching. We don't make mistakes, we just have happy accidents. Anything that you want to do, total power. The world, you're the creator. Find freedom on this canvas. Believe that you can do it.